The cordyline, a beautiful plant that every garden should have. They look fantastic and the colours just stand out so nice. And today I'm going to show you how to propagate one of these just from a cutting. It's so easy to do. Now here I've got a nice big bushy one. It's got lots of little leaves and branches growing off it. And this will be a nice one to take cuttings from. Now when you do cut these, the beauty about them is that they send up new shoots that pop out, which is really handy. So this one might send out one, two or three from here. But what you need to do is find yourself a nice old growth, woody piece of stem like this, and this would be perfect. And basically, I'm just going to cut some off down a bit lower on the plant. And now it's time to go and pop this cutting. Let's do that. Okay, so now I've got the cordyline cutting home. What I want to do is just clean it up a bit, take off all these dead leaves. And that's what you can do when the plant gets older too, is as the leaves die, just take them off because it'll make it look a whole lot nicer. And I've got myself a nice deepish sort of pot here. And I've also got a good quality all-purpose potting mix as well. So I'll start by filling up my pot with the potting mix. Give it a push down, leaving a nice couple of centimetres from the top. Perfect. And now with the end part of the cordyline here, what I want to do is, I'll see how deep this goes. Right. So that comes to about here. So from about there down, I'll just get my secateurs and I'll just lightly scrape off some of this here, some of the bark, exposing some of the green underneath. That's just very lightly shaving it off. Hopefully now this is where the roots will come out from. So all I need to do now is just stick the cordyline in the pot. Make sure it's nice and straight in the pot as well. Push it down, add some more soil if you need to. And then of course, give it a nice drink. Making sure that the water's draining out of it nicely, because they don't like to sit in water, but they do like to have their roots wet, as they do come from a tropical climate. So make sure the water's running out, give them a good drink, and you'll probably want to water this every day for the first week, making sure the water's draining through nicely. That'll help promote the roots to come out from the stem so it can survive better on its own. And after that, you should water it about once a week, making sure that the soil never gets bone dry, because if it gets too bone dry, the ends of the leaves will die and turn brown. So you want to keep the root system nice and moist, and that'll help the leaves grow nice and strong and keep that beautiful colour that they have. Now they do like fertiliser as well, so don't feel afraid to give them some. Make sure you water it in straight away, and if any get on the leaves as well, make sure you wash it off. Now the cordyline plant comes in different varieties and different sizes and different colours. Here are a couple of examples here. You get the white leaves, you get the broad leaves, you get the thinner leaves. They're just a really nice plant and are a really good feature plant for a garden. They are quite drought tolerant as well, but they do require some sort of watering, as they are from a more tropical sort of climate. And if you do intend on having it in a cooler climate, just keep them in a pot and then bring them inside during the winter months. Now here's one I did a cutting from about 12 months ago. And well, to be honest, I haven't really taken that good care of it. I just stuck it in the garden here, and this garden has a watering system, so it does get quite a bit of water. But you can see the root system here is growing out. It's growing in the lines that it looks like I've scraped. I just need to top this up with a bit more soil but also it has rooted into the ground as well. So the root system is working nice and fine. That's why I haven't been too concerned, but I will repot that now that I can see that how bad it is. So I'll do that. But they are a really nice plant. They give a really nice pop of colour. They're great for indoors in bright, sunny or really well lit areas as well. They can tolerate full sun and part shade, and they can also tolerate full shade. But if they're going to be in the full shade, they sort of lose their colour and vibrancy and sort of regress back to like a boring sort of colour, a bit like this. So the more sun they sort of get, the more colour that they will produce. This one here has been in full shade pretty much, and you can see by the leaves there that it has lost that real reddish colour. There's a few leaves there that still have it, but it's not quite like this one here, which has been getting quite a lot more sunshine. Now these can be susceptible to mold growth if you leave the leaves wet. So if you are going to hose them, make sure you just hose them at the base of the plant and try and avoid hosing the leaves off. Although in saying that, you can hose the leaves, but if you're going to do that, water them in the morning time so the leaves have time to dry off and they're not sitting all wet and moist overnight for a prolonged period of time, because that can start causing mold growth here where the leaf joins the stem, and then that'll attract all the ants, and well, it's probably something you don't particularly want. But there you go, the Cordyline plant, one of my favorites. Great for indoors, great for outdoors, great for sunny spots, great for dry areas, great for wet areas that have good drainage. They're just the perfect plant. I absolutely love them. I hope you love one too. Go get yourself one, stick it inside in a nice sunny area, and it will brighten up any room. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Greg the Gardener.